background of all of these is black, and in most cases it's satin. I might make a few kits with something else, but most of them will be black satin. And the satin is kind of slithery fabric, hard to manage. So we mount it onto some junk fabric to just make it a little stiffer and easier to handle. So here's any old piece of fabric that's not going to show. And once again, we don't know what size these are going to be when they're finished, so I'll give you more than you need. And I just like to pin perpendicular to the edge of what I'm sewing on. A lot of things are mounted to make them give them more body, like fur coat linings are mounted on flannel to make them soft and cushy. And you can mount a coat. So we sew around the edges of this, and then we treat these two fabrics as one. And it's just a loose basting stitch. Once again, the stitching will never show. You can use any color thread you want. It's kind of just a temporary step. And even if you're fusing it, this step probably should be done by machine. This is a panel that's partially completed. And here's our fabric. This does not happen to be satin in this case. But once again, I mounted it on the junk fabric just to give it a little more body. And see how I can use any goofy colored thread. It's not going to show, and you can use up something goofy. Save the good for later. This is all about recycling. So next we're going to take a piece of fabric and pin our designs on it. So here's a piece of background, and here are some of the silk pieces that I have prepared. On this finished one, I discovered quite accidentally that I liked the look of a black border on the edges, except I didn't make the background fabric big enough for it. So if you were smart, you would leaves the extra black on the background, and we'll cover that with the decorative bit, but that gives you the background to support it. However, this little piece I have is too short for that, so I would have normally left this bit of black, except I don't quite have enough on this one, so this one's going to be just a different technique. Here's the piece with the edge all ironed under. And then I'm just going to pin it. I like to pin it a little farther apart than I will ultimately, so that you make sure you get it all laid down flat. But then don't be stingy with the pins. It's better to put in more pins and not have it shift on you. I like long pins, they're easier to lift. I only pin one piece of fabric at a time, because if you pin several of them, the heads of the pins are going to get in the way of the one that's next to you. And I also think you should take the pins out rather than trying to sew over them. Often you can sew over them, but sometimes it messes up the stitch. And part of the beauty of this technique, if you look at this guy, is to see that there's this little stitch that leaves just a tiny bit of a decorative edge. So now we're ready to sew one. Here I am threaded in a drab color left over from the basting I did. And what I often do is just start sewing because it's fun, except you really should thread your machine up in the correct color before you're ready to use it, so that you don't, it's really annoying if you sew 3 inches in the wrong color and have to yank it out. So I like to sew in a matching color, but you could also, if you don't have too many matching colors, you could sew in black and it would give a different kind of look to it. But we're going to look through the blue drawer here and find some green thread that's the right color. I thought I had turquoise thread in here. And if you can't match the thread exactly, it's better to pick a slightly darker shade rather than a slightly lighter shade. And once again, the bobbin does not matter. You can use any goofy thing on the bobbin. But you will be changing thread a lot with this project. Unless you choose to do the black thread version. I like a small zigzag. My machine goes like 1 through 6, and I like about a 2.5 or 2 for the width and set it on zig. And what I like is one edge is right on the black and one edge is on the fabric. So look real close here. This end piece, you don't need to zig the rest of it. You could just baste it. So I turned it back to straight. Ooh, see, that looks pretty nice. I turned it back to straight and basting the long stitch. I'm just going the edge quickly. I always have put the needle in to pivot. Cavalier about sewing over the pins. I think that's pretty cool looking. Let's put on another piece. My original idea for this was to have varying widths of the black showing, skinny to wide. And always remember, see how I have like a wide bit and then a skinny bit, that it's divided in thirds. It's not so beautiful to divide things in halves. Thirds and two-thirds are more beautiful. So vary this width, but make it interesting and not repetitive. So that's, now I get to pin the next piece on here. And another idea I had, you don't even necessarily have to keep the spacing everywhere. Something is fishy here. So I can't seem to make this piece fit the way I know it does. So I think I screwed something up. Either I got the order wrong or I made something upside down. So looking here, I can tell that these pieces that are not quite prepared, I know that those fit together and that fits together. Oh, look, this piece fits there. So this is the piece I should have been using. Because look how it fits there and it fits here. So that's why you have to arrange these in a nice order and keep some sort of order to it. It will keep your sanity. And I have made them upside down, and it's like, well, then you make a new piece or you have to put a seam in it. The other thing I like about these is they're a little bit flexible. So maybe instead of having the black show the whole way, you can actually make the black completely disappear somewhere if you want. See what that looks like. Just a different look if you want a different look. See how we've just got the black showing and two little spikes coming in from the sides? That's kind of interesting, I think. When you're pinning like this into a table, don't use your good dining room table because you will scar the finish with the points of your pins. Pin on a cutting mat or not on your good table. This looks pretty cool with just two little points of black coming in. But see how the pins would be in the way of sewing the previous one, which is why I like to just sew one piece at a time. Plus, I probably need a different color thread now. Sometimes you can use the same color thread twice, but often you have to change thread. I think it's a good habit to, when you're done with a piece, take the colored thread off, and that reminds you that you need to be looking for another color, because I really hate sewing the wrong color first. Okay, ready for more sewing. Or thread check. I put this layered piece of thread across my fabric and I decided this is a good color. I'm not even going to change the thread. And lucky me. And I had left it set on straight, so I'll do a tiny bit of straight here. I'm going to set back up to my small size zig. See how the ends are running wild? They're sort of not beautifully aligned. It doesn't matter. We're going to cut it all off later. Sewing pieces on till you get to the point where it looks like this. And the next step after this is truing it up, because now it's all cattywampus and funny because we didn't care about the edges. So we need to get two lines that are parallel, and I will get out a square and show you how to do that. But first, there's some other options about how to treat these pieces. You know, here we have the black showing the whole way, and here we have the black showing in pieces. I have an idea about an overlapped way to do it. So when you overlap them, you only need to treat one side of the piece, not both sides like we've been. So we need to cut out one side with the half-inch seam allowance. And we really do not need the half-inch seam allowance on the other side. So this is the side I'm going to have be stitched. So we need to clip that one. But I think what I want to do is overlap this piece, or actually underlap it, with the piece that's already there. So I will sew just one side of that piece on. And we'll stuff it under so that that line disappears after I've got that folded too. So that'll just be a slightly different look. So let me go sew this and get this ironed, and then we can test out, see what that looks like. So this is an attempt at my first idea of overlapping some of them, see what happens. Perhaps the smart thing to do is work in the opposite direction that I'm working in right now, who knows? And I think I'm not going to sew this edge until I decide what I want to do with it. See here where I have some thread showing? I can just clip that because it's a basting thread. And then I like to use a blunt needle, which doesn't get caught in the thread, to pull the stitches out. Gone. I can do that here too. Beautiful. Another trick, if you have a little thread that's slightly off. Oh, wait a minute, I've got the wrong color thread here. Once again with feeling. Okay. See here where I skipped a stitch and I have a little orange stitch on the black, which annoys me. Just take a black marker and touch the thread. And that will make it disappear. And then you'll be happy.